as you can see, I'm moving the fly, giving it some action, making it look like a real little bait fish that might be in a bit of trouble, struggling. Let it go down deep into the holes, let it drop on that tungsten bead, and then always keep the fly moving, always giving it that look of life. It's the most important thing of all, let it drop into those holes, and then those little twitches that give it that impression of life. The most important thing of all when we're streamer fishing. And it's quite an exciting form of fishing. It's when the fish appears, he suddenly appears very quickly from nowhere, out of suddenly seems to have materialised out of thin air or thin water as the case may be. And suddenly your heart pounds as a big fish approaches the fly. And the important thing to do here when we're streamer fishing is not to slow the fly down, not to slow the retrieve, but to keep the fly moving or even increase its pace. To give the impression that for the trout that the meal about to escape. And then he's more inclined to take the fly. There's no such thing in the trout's world as a bait item which is going to sit around and let him wait to be eaten. So it's important that the fly acts as a natural small fish in peril would do. When we're streamer fishing, we're not using light tippets. It's a very, very heavy line. This is 6 pounds. There's no point in going light. So we can really put some effort into playing the fish very hard. If we intend to release the fish, which I will do in a second, by playing the fish hard, it means he'll recover very, very quickly. And that's another beauty of streamer fishing.